Hi everyone, Habibi here. In this video, I'm going to share a new thing for you for free. You can download this entire Unity project that I'm going to share with you, and the link of the download I will put it on the description of this video. So here I have a start scene, and also I have level 1 scene and level 2 scene. I call this project a level navigation system. I have a start scene here. Then in the scene you can see a button. If I click that button, I will go to the level 1. On the level 1, which is the sphere here on the center, I can move toward this blue object. I call it a door. If I reach this door, I will automatically jump into the second level, which is a cylinder on its center. And if I go to this door, I will go back to the first level. So let me explain it by demonstration. Let me start the first scene, the start scene, and I click play. Here is an entry scene and a button here. Let me start. So here I'm now in a level 1. Level 1 has a sphere, giant sphere on its center. Now I'm going to reach the door, the blue door. Once I reach this door, I will jump into the second level, which is level 2. Now I'm on level 2. Then if I go back to the level 1, I can reach this door to go back. Now I am on level 1. So that is the demonstration. Next I will explain how it works. And you will need this explanation if you are going to use this system and modify it for your need. So before I explain everything, I'm going to ask you, if you are not a subscriber yet, please subscribe to my channel and hit like button. And if you are okay to support me on Patreon, please go to my Patreon page and be my supporter. Only $5 per month, you can support me to keep continue creating tutorials and free source codes for you. Okay, and the explanation is this way. Let me start from the start scene. Here is a start scene. I have a canvas here and a button. This button has a script in it. I attach the script here on the canvas. The script is this button click. So I attach this script to the canvas, and this button I drag and drop the canvas to this slot, and I choose this button clicks open scene, this one. Then here I type level 1 to start the level 1. If I change it to level 2, after we click this start button, we will jump into the second level, not the first level. Let's test it. Now we are on level 2. Enter this door to go to level 1. Now we are in level 1, and we can go back to level 2 by entering this door. That's for the first scene. And let me change it back to level 1. Let me show you what is it in the level 1. Level 1, we have this object here, player loader. This is a prefab. If you want to create another level, you can use this prefab. You can drag and drop it to your scene. Inside this player loader, it has a player loader script. Which is this script? What this script does is when the scene is loaded, this script will bring the player to the scene. The player, which is the first person controller player rig that I have made earlier on my previous tutorial, this is the folder that I have made on my previous tutorial. I move the prefab to this resources folder. On previous tutorial, this prefab was here, so now it is in the resources folder. Then this player loader here on the level 1, when the scene is loaded, the level 1 is loaded, it brings player rig to the scene. Then when the player rig is brought into the scene, let's open this. Here is the player object, player capsule and the camera. I attached a new script here, player positioner. Player positioner is here. What this script does, the player positioner, is when the player is loaded into the scene, it will move automatically to an entry point. Where is the entry point? Basically, the entry point is the position or a coordinate that the player will be there for first time in this scene. Basically, the starting point is just an empty game object with this name format. SP, it stands for starting point, and 1 is the number. And here in this level 1 scene, we have a door. This door is a cube with a mesh collider, but this collider is working as a trigger. So I check this trigger mark here, and it has door tag. If you don't have this door tag, you need to create a tag named door, and you need to apply door tag to this door object. The name format of this door is like this: door 2. This is the name of the door. It must be this way. And this 2 is the number of level that we are going to go on when we reach this door. And this number after this dash is the number of starting point on that level. So if we go to this door, we are going to open the scene number 2, and we are going to place the player at the starting point number 1. So let's go open this level 2, and let's see where is the position of the entry point or starting point number 1. Open it. Here is starting point number 1. So when we are inside this level for first time, the player will be here exactly. We can also move this starting point. For example, we can place it here. Then okay, let's try to run the game. Go to start scene and start the game. Now we are here. We are exactly above this cylinder. Maybe we can change its color. Let's go back to the scene one. And go back to the scene 2. Now we are here. We are on this cylinder. Here is the player. Okay, now let's create another level. So you will see how we can add another level. Let me add the next level. I call it level 3. Let's open it. Here we delete the main camera. We don't need this camera because we already have a camera on our player. Our player is here. We call this player and bring it to the scene when we enter this scene. So in this level 3, we are going to add a plane as a ground. Let me position it on 0, 0, and 0 coordinate. Scale it up. And I'm going to bring it a bit lower. Then, to distinguish between this scene and the previous scene, I will add an object here, for example, a large cube. So this is the empty scene, and the next thing we need is to bring this object, entry starting point, and also a door. Let me just copy these two first and paste it here. Now we can position, we can adjust the position of this starting point. Let me put it here or here. And this door, the name of this door is door 21-2. It means this door will bring you to the level 1 and entry point 2. I will rename it to another name. I want this door to bring me to the level 2 and the entry point or starting point number 2. And let's go back to the level 2. Make sure that we have a starting point number 2 then. Here we only have starting point number 1. I'm going to add starting point number 2. So basically we can simply duplicate this starting point and place it here. And we adjust the rotation. So let's face this center object. So because this is starting point number 2, we must name it correctly, SP2. Now that's all. Now if we start the game and we start the scene. Oh, I'm sorry, we did not add a door on level 2 to bring us to the level 3. So here the door, this door is bringing us, will bring us to level 1 and entry point or starting point 2. I'm going to duplicate this door and rename it to door 2 and entry point 1. Save it and let's go to the start scene. Then we run the game. Let's go to the door. We are going to the second level. Now it is the second level. I need to go to level 3, so I don't know which one is the door for the level 3. Let me check again. Oh, I'm sorry, I did not change the position of this second door. So let me bring it close to this edge here, and let's start again. We are going to the second level. Now we are here, and that one is the door to level 3. Let's go there. I know that when we jump from this cylinder, it goes down slowly because we maybe to solve it we can add a mass to this capsule. Maybe we can increase this mass to 3 or 5. You can experiment with it. So let me go to the third level. And we are going to the third level. It is still level 2, so there must be a problem. This is the door to level 2 and entry point 1. I must rename it to level 3. I didn't rename it correctly, so this one must be correct. This door is going to bring us to level 3. Okay, I'm sorry to retry this. This time it must be correct. This door should bring us to the third level. Scene 3 is not added to the build, so I forgot that one. We need to add this level 3 to this build. Let's add it. Now this time everything must be okay. Level 3, we are coming. No cameras rendering, why? Yeah, and again, another thing that I forgot is to add this player loader to this level 3. So now this time it must be absolutely okay and correct. We have player loader and we have starting point, and also we have a door to bring us to the second level. Let's start again. This time we have to go to the third level. Now we are on third level. Remember that long cube here? We are on the third level. And that is a door to bring us back to the second level. Let's go there. Here we are in the, I think it is, yes, it is the second level. Okay, that's all for this video. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you have any question, please ask me. I will try to answer your question as I can.